Hey guys, what's up? Welcome back to my channel. As you can see by the title today, we are going to be talking about dermaplaning at home, waxing, the differences. I have a specific product I want to talk to you guys about, and we're actually going to shave part of my face in the video. So we're going to go ahead and jump in and get started. If you want to go ahead and give this video a like, it really helps out my channel, as well as subscribing. I am a licensed esthetician in the state of Michigan, so all of this is based off of my experience and my knowledge in my training, but some of this is my opinion as well. So we're just going to go ahead and jump right into it. Okay, you guys, so I am up close and personal. I want to talk to you about a few things really quickly. I have seen a lot of controversy lately about shaving, waxing, pros, cons, hair growing back, all the things. As a licensed esthetician, I also talk to people about the benefits of shaving and waxing, the difference in regrowth, and all of those things. So I think it's a really important topic to talk about. A lot of people feel like the beauty industry is maybe shoving women in a direction where they feel like they have to shave or wax their face. And that is 100% not true, at least from my perspective. A lot of the services that I offer or the things that I talk to my clients about come from a place of them asking me, in the sense of they have a lot of peach fuzz and they want to remove it for whatever reason. They're self-conscious of it. They don't like it. For some women, the peach fuzz on their face, they have so much of it that it causes their makeup to look a little bit more cakey. There's a lot of other benefits to removing the hair and the dead skin from your face, which both dermaplaning and waxing. Here's some common myths I want to talk quickly about as far as regrowth and things like that. I have seen a lot of people say that the hair on your face is actually there as a protective barrier. That is 100% not true. The hair on your face does not serve you any purpose as far as protection goes. Okay, these little fine hairs are not going to do anything to protect your skin. There's no harm in removing them as long as it's done properly with the correct pre and post care, and you're doing it in a safe manner, whether with the correct information or having it done by a professional who knows what they're doing, like myself. Another myth that I see a lot of people say is that you need the facial hair on your face in order for the oils to travel out of your pores, and the oil on your face uses those hairs to escape from your pores. Once again, that's 100% not true. The pores or the follicles on your face, oil escapes from regardless of whether you have peach fuzz or not. Some women struggle with it more than others, depending on what your skin type is. I myself have very, very, very dry skin, and so I don't generally have any oil on my face at all. Other women have very oily skin, combo skin. There's lots of difference. The most common myth that I see people and hear people ask me about, talk about, is the hair is going to grow back thicker, coarser, faster, etc. So that's also not true in a majority of cases. Everyone's regrowth rate is completely different. Some people produce more hair than others. Some people's hair grow faster than others. Every person's hair cycle is completely different. Our hair goes through three stages. I'm not going to get into all that, but we all have a hair growth cycle and it's different for every single person. Now, the reason why, if when removing the hair from your face, it will not grow back darker, thicker, coarser, is purely because of the structure inside of our follicles and the hormones inside of your body. So what I mean by that is the keratin structure inside of the cells where your hair grows from determines from basically birth how dark the hair is going to be, how coarse it's going to be, how quickly it's going to grow, etc. It's going to differ based on male or female, as well as the hormones in our body are going to change this as well. So for example, men have men and women both have a hormone in our body called androgen hormone. And men actually have a lot more of it than women do. And so everyone always says, well, men shave their face and their hair get coarser as well, which is true because the hormone ratio in men is different than women. So that androgen hormone is what determines the coarseness, the thickness of the hair. So like my son Theodore, he's almost 2 years old. He has hair on his face, but it's peach fuzz, right? So as he gets older, that androgen hormone is going to increase. And then as he gets into his teenage years, his early adulthood, and he starts to shave, now the hair is going to start to grow back coarser, thicker, darker, because that androgen hormone is increasing. Women do not have a high amount of of androgen in their body, which is why we can shave and remove hair from our face and have it still be nice and thin and beautiful peach fuzz. Now, there are exceptions to this. Women who struggle with hormonal imbalances, things like PCOS and other disorders like that, once again, cause a hormone imbalance. And so this can cause women who struggle with those disorders to remove the hair from their face and it grow back differently because the hormones are not where they should be. They're not in the correct amounts. So it's always really important to talk to a professional dermatologist or someone that you trust that has expertise in the medical field or training. If you suffer with a disorder like that, that affects your hormones, to say, hey, you know, if I shave or wax, will my hair grow back faster, thicker, coarser, etc.? So shaving will never, ever, ever, neither will waxing, alter the state of the cells and the structure. It's already predetermined inside your follicle. Shaving or waxing cannot alter that. So if you shave or wax your face and it comes back thicker, darker, coarser, it is because there's something hormonally that is happening. Some women who go through menopause as they get older struggle with this as well. So I know a lot of women who shave and who have been shaving for years and still have the exact same regrowth. So we're gonna get into this a little bit. I'm gonna kind of show you guys a quick demo, talk to you about a product that I really love. As a licensed esthetician, I do offer dermaplaning in my salon as a professional service. Basically, what dermaplaning is, if you don't know, is we are taking a surgical grade scalpel or a medical grade scalpel and using a facial oil to remove the vellus hair or the peach fuzz and the dead skin off of your face using small strokes against the skin. This is done by a professional because of the type of blade that we use. It is more unsafe to use at home on yourself because it's sharper. You can't necessarily get all the right angles. There's no guard on it, things like that. So it is really important to get dermaplaning done in a salon or a medical spa or something like that by a professional if you want to have that medical grade scalpel used. Now, there are forms of dermaplaning that you can do at home, which is what I'm going to show you guys. I'm going to leave all of the information in the comments below. I will have a discount code for you if you'd like to purchase this product because it is something that I personally use. I do not professionally dermaplane my own skin. I don't get it done by another esthetician, so this is what I do. I normally wax underneath my brows and sometimes wax my lips, but that is kind of preference. So, but when you are removing the hair with a razor, you're obviously cutting the shaft off, which can cause the hair to grow back maybe more quickly than if you were to wax. So if you go to a salon, an esthetician, anyone, and you're gonna get your face completely waxed, when you are waxing someone's hair off of their face, you are ripping the follicle out of place, basically, which is why getting your face waxed takes it longer to grow back. It's the same thing with the rest of the hair on your body. I've been waxing my armpits now for quite a while and I don't have to remove the hair as often because every single time I wax, I am completely removing the entire bulb and shaft of the hair rather than just cutting it off. Dermaplaning professionally done in a salon or a medical spa really only should be done every 4 to 6 weeks because it is more of an extreme form of exfoliation. You want to make sure that you're not over exfoliating your skin. And so for a lot of my clients, they will just put in a dermaplaning add-on session into like every other facial that they do or whatever they like to do. I do have some clients that come in specifically for dermaplaning. It's kind of a mini facial in itself because of the products that we use. But yeah, that's kind of the difference. Now, when you're dermaplaning at home, the product that I'm going to show you guys here is the Jill Razor. I'm going to talk to you guys about why this product is different than what you can find in the drugstore or anything like that, and kind of walk you guys through how to properly dermaplane at home and the benefits and all that stuff. So the Jill Razor was created by some amazing women who have been shaving for a long time and did not find great success with other razors that they bought in stores. And so they created the Jill Razor. So this is their starter kit right here, super cute packaging. And what you will get inside of it is you are going to get your actual handle here where you're going to insert your blades. The Jill Razor is completely recyclable in the sense that you can recycle this piece and you can also recycle the blades as well. You're going to get your gunk pad to wipe your blade off with. You're going to get your starter shave guide, which I actually don't have with me, but I'm going to talk about how you can get get a digital form of that if you'd like to. And then you're also going to get a set of blades. And the Jill razor comes with two different sizes. You're going to have a petite blade and you're going to have a larger blade. And those are used for different parts of your face. When you purchase the starter kit, you're going to get one set of two blades. This pack right here is, I actually am signed up for their subscription. So every month I receive two sets of blades for $6.80 delivered to my door. Because Jill does recommend shaving every 2 weeks, it's going to vary person to person, depending on how often you want to shave, how quickly your hair grows back, how picky you are, things like that. Once again, it's important to not shave too much because this is still a form of exfoliation and you can over exfoliate your skin to the point that you cause irritation and breakouts, and we don't want that. So this is actually the subscription where you get two sets of Jill razors. So if you're shaving every 2 weeks or approximately every two weeks, one shipment of these will potentially last you an entire month. And then from there, you can also purchase these separately on the website for $6.80 as well. You can, you know, if you want to buy four or five of these just to have laying around for when you're ready to shave, you're more than welcome to do that. I prefer the monthly subscription. That way I have them come to my door and I don't have to worry about ordering them or forgetting or whatever it may be. So the other at-home dermaplaning razors are not as beneficial as well because a lot of times they don't come with the proper information. It's not just as easy as picking up a blade and running it over your face and calling it good, right? There's proper steps that we have to take and to make sure that we're protecting our skin, we're keeping it safe, and we're doing it properly. So I'm going to walk through this with you guys. I'm going to pull my hair back here and I'm going to get kind of up close and personal to show you. I have not shaved in well over a month. I definitely have a lot of regrowth, and the way that I see it is I actually have a mole on the side of my face that actually produces a few hairs. So I believe if I turn my light up a little bit more, you can maybe see from this angle, there's the peach fuzz on the side. You can definitely see my upper lip area tends to get a little bit darker because I do have, you can see it, I have peach fuzz there. And it's mostly here on my cheeks. There is definitely some peach fuzz here, but the two different blades are going to be used for different areas of your face. Packaging is so cute. Once again, these blades are also recyclable, which is super awesome. Normally, products that have blades in them are not recyclable because they have to be put in a sharps container because there is a sharp product in it as far as a blade or a razor goes. The Jill razor is designed for you to be able to remove that blade. That way you can recycle the pieces and throw the blade away in a sharps container or wherever it may be. So these are your two sizes. This is your petite blade. This is mostly going to be used for the chin area and underneath your brows and in between your brows. And then your larger size blade is going to be used for your forehead and your cheeks. Some women also experience hair that grows maybe further down their neck, which you can shave as well. But basically, you guys probably already know what's about to happen. You take your lid off of your handle and you insert whatever size blade you are wanting to use and you are ready to go. Super sleek, super lightweight, easy to travel with because it has that lid as well. So if you want to take it somewhere with you, you can do that. So the shave guide that I was talking about, why it's so important is because it has all the proper information in there. When you are shaving, you want to make sure that first of all, you're working with clean hands. You want to make sure that you're cleansing your face to remove any makeup, debris, anything like that. And then you also want to make sure that you have a proper skin barrier. So we're going to go ahead and cleanse. I'm going to show you guys some cool products you can grab on Amazon that work really, really well for this. And then we will go ahead and shave. But basically, the shave guide is going to walk you through step by step what you need to do in order to shave properly. And so I think that's where Jill really stands out from a lot of other companies is a lot of companies sell those plastic rinky dinky ones at Walmart, Target. If you use those and you love them, no shame at all. As long as you're shaving properly, it doesn't matter what you use. I just really prefer this product because I see a higher quality in it. I see more benefits to it. So the shave guide is really important because it talks to people about the proper steps to take. If you are shaving your face dry, you are doing yourself a disservice and you can also really irritate your skin. So in your shave kit, it's going to be a little shave guide pamphlet that you can flip through. You can also go to their website at tryjill.com and they have a page called the Jill Method where they talk about how to properly prep, shave, and nourish your skin. So basically just what I talked about, we want to make sure that we're going to cleanse our face. These you can actually get on Amazon. I have these linked below in my bio. They are compressed sponges, which are super awesome. They're super thin. You put them in water and they expand and they turn into this. I have some warm water here so I can wash my face. They expand into a little disc, and this is super great for traveling, for single use, you know, things like this. I generally have a rag at home that I use to wash my face that I can, you know, wash and reuse over and over again because it is more friendly to the environment. But basically what we're going to do is we're just going to wet the face down just a little bit to make sure that our products can emulsify, and we are going to cleanse and make sure that everything is nice and clean. I have not put any makeup on today. That's the other thing with shaving, is you generally want to do it on a day or before you go to bed, a day that you're not going to be wearing makeup, or before you go to bed. You can put makeup on after you shave, but your pores are nice and open and they are kind of succumb to the environment, especially with it starting to get more cold outside. It really is better to make sure that you shave before you go to bed if you can, or shave on a day that, once again, you're not going to be putting any makeup on, just because your pores are going to be nice and open and you don't want to shove a bunch of product into that. So for your cleanser, you can use anything that you have available to you. The biggest thing with shaving and pre-cleansing is to make sure that your products don't have any active ingredients or are not chemically based. So using something that is organic, that has really good ingredients in it, nothing that has like Retin A or any type of medicated product, because you're going to be opening up those pores. You want to make sure that you're not putting a chemical product that is too strong that can cause your skin to be irritated. So that's really, really important. Same thing with the facial oil and the moisturizer you're going to use after. You want to make sure nothing is chemically based and it doesn't have any active ingredients in it. You also want to give your skin several hours, if not a whole day, before you start using your Retin-A products again, just because you can really irritate your skin if you shove products like that into open pores. So as you can see, we are cleansing very, very well, getting in all the nooks and crannies here. And then I just used a gel cleanser that I use here at my salon, works for my skin type. And we are just going to rinse all that off. So I'm just going to take a clean paper towel here, gently pat my skin dry. And I'm going to show you guys how this works. Now, like I said before, I do have clients that come in and get their face waxed once a month, once every 6 weeks. That does really work for some people. Waxing does not just randomly cause irritation to the skin. Some people are more sensitive to it than others, which is why shaving is a good alternative. But shaving is not also a one-size-fits-all thing. Sometimes people don't want to have to worry about doing stuff at home. They just want to be able to come into a salon and lay on a table and have someone else wax their face, and that's perfectly fine. I am just here to tell you, do what works best for you. Do what makes you feel good, but make sure that you are doing it safely and you're doing it with the information or a professional that knows what they're doing. That way you're keeping your skin protected. The skin is the largest organ of our body, and it's really, really important to make sure that we protect it, we nourish it, and we take care of it properly. And so there's a lot of really great information out there that you can find, a lot of great skincare products that don't break the bank, that don't have to be hundreds and hundreds of dollars. So there's lots of options out there. But the next thing that you need before you start shaving is some type of skin barrier. We always recommend a facial oil of some sort to put on the skin as you're shaving, because once again, if you are shaving dry, you are going to have a higher possibility of cutting yourself. You can irritate your skin. You want to make sure you have something on the skin to help the blade glide and to make sure that you're keeping that protective barrier there. So once again, any facial oil will work that works with your skin, not chemically based, doesn't have any active ingredients in it. It doesn't have to be $100 facial oil. I have a vitamin C oil here that I picked up from TJ Maxx. People really like coconut oil. If you're sensitive to coconut, obviously don't use that. A lot of people who have aloe vera plants in their house will just slice an aloe vera plant open and use the aloe vera. That's a really great option to use as well. The benefits of shaving, which I don't think I've actually mentioned yet, are obviously you're going to be able to remove that hair from your face. Once again, a lot of people self-conscious of it, don't like it, whatever the reason is, it honestly doesn't matter. I could really care less. I love the skincare benefits of dermaplaning. I could really care less whether the hair is there or not, because like I said, I normally wax my lip and my brows to keep those nice and clean. But your makeup can apply smoother because you're removing that layer of dead skin as well as the peach fuzz. It's also a form of gentle exfoliation as well. Some of the other benefits from dermaplaning at home can also be that if you have acne scarring or any type of hyperpigmentation, over time, removing that layer of dead skin that's on top also helps to encourage new cell growth, which can cause new skin cells to grow there, which can cause that pigmentation or the acne scarring to eventually fade or even disappear. Once again, they're not guaranteed results. It really depends on person to person, and it's really one of those things that you have to do for a little while to see if it works for you and if it's something that you want to add into your routine. So we're going to jump right into this. Last thing really quickly is if you do have active acne breakouts, you want to make sure to shave around those areas and not on top of them. It's really, really important that you do this because shaving over top of active acne breakouts can cause you to spread bacteria across your entire face, which could not only cause irritation to that area that's broken out, but also spread that bacteria to other places on your face as well. Because you're shaving and you're kind of opening up those pores, you're basically taking that bacteria from the acne and spreading it all over your face, and you do not want that. So it's really important to make sure that you get your acne kind of under control, or at least not as an active breakout before you shave, or if you just have a little area, like I said, just shave around it. So I'm gonna start with my wider blade here and use a swiping direction with the oil. You guys will see exactly how to do that. So I've got a little bit of this vitamin C oil on the back of my hand, and I'm just going to place a generous amount of this. You definitely don't want to rub it in all the way because you want it to be on top of the skin, but I'm just going to do a small little. You're going to take your razor and hold your skin taut, and you are just, I'm going to try and move this out of the way here. Just going to gently do strokes like this. And you can see right away, I don't have super dark peach fuzz. It looks like I do when I'm shaving it, but it's not super noticeable. But as you start to remove it, you can see how much hair is actually there. Isn't that insane? So you wanna make sure you're holding your skin taut and just making nice, even strokes. It's super satisfying. You can hear it and it feels really good. It does not hurt. This Jill razor has been designed to have a guard on it. You can see that little plop of hair that I just put on there is so cool. It's such a satisfying thing. It feels so good. And so I just did that little section there. So we're gonna go ahead and grab a little bit more oil and kind of do another section. But basically you're just going to keep doing this until you've covered your entire face. You've done all the areas. You don't have to shave your entire face, of course. If you just have, you know, a little area here on your forehead or wherever, it's totally preference and totally up to you. You definitely don't want to get anywhere in here near your eyeball. That skin is a lot more fragile and thin, way easier to cut, and there's generally not hair that grows there, so it's not really something you have to worry about shaving anyway. So same thing, just going to gently make light stroking motions. You want to hold the razor at a little bit of an angle, but you don't need to press into the skin. It's just a gentle gliding motion, and continue to pull the skin taut as you get closer. And then of course we always want to finish with a moisturizer to add that moisture back into the skin. The other important thing to note as well is if you have maybe like thicker, darker, if you have a few hairs that maybe grow out of your chin, it's important to remove those with tweezers. The Jill razor was not created for coarse, thick hair like that. The Jill razor was created for peach fuzz, and so it's really important to make sure that you remove those with tweezers and not the razor itself. But once again, just light stroking motions till you get down to that section there, and you just want to hold the skin as taut as possible. Just gentle stroking motions. Easy to do. You can go further down on your neck if you'd like to. You just obviously want to make sure you're being careful with. So I'm going to do my upper lip here. So I switched the Jill razor here to this petite blade. Just going to put a light layer of oil here. I between the brows, which is really great for this petite size blade, and underneath the brows as well. I'm gonna leave those alone because I do like to wax those. So just like I'm talking about now, everything is personal preference. But once again, you want to use a fresh set of blades every single time you shave, as it is really, really important to make sure that you're not spreading that bacteria. I don't have any product left on my face. All the oil has been removed with the blade. You can see how glowy my skin is, how fresh it looks. It feels very, very nice, and it has so many amazing benefits to it. So I hope you guys found this video helpful. As I showed you before, I had shaved, you know, about a month back, and everything that you saw on my face was my regrowth. So you could barely see it. I get a little bit of a shadow here on my lip, but you know, if you're afraid to try it, I totally get it. There's a lot of misinformation out there. A lot of people sharing that the hair grows back thicker, coarser, that it's going to destroy your skin, it's going to cause irritation. All of those things can be true if it's not done properly. So that's why I love Jill, because they offer all of that amazing information that goes with it to make sure that people are properly taking care of their skin. And then if you are going to cleanse again, that's totally fine. You don't have to cleanse again. You're just going to finish off with some type of moisturizer to make sure that you're adding that moisture back into the skin. Once again, you want to use something that's as natural as possible. You want to make sure there's no active ingredients in it and no chemically based products as well. So you can go in with a nourishing facial oil. This is just a soothing cream that I really like. Make sure you use something that works for your skin type, but make sure to not use anything with any chemicals or active ingredients. And you can see, obviously now I have product on my face and my skin is soaking it up. But even before I put that product on, my skin was glowy and it just looked beautiful. So over time, as you do this, your skin is going to love you. Once again, new cell growth, new cell regeneration. There's a lot of other amazing benefits to it. If you guys have any questions at all, please drop them in the comments. I'd be more than happy to answer them, have a conversation with you. I know a lot of people are pretty timid with this topic just because there is so much misinformation. There's a lot of crap that's being shared, and I think it's freaking a lot of people out. So I'm not an expert. Like I said, I am a licensed esthetician, and I do have some knowledge as far as the hair growth and the structure and all that stuff, but I don't know everything. So if you guys know something I don't, please feel free to share it with me in the comments. But once again, I'd be happy to answer any questions. I will have a discount code for you guys. You can go ahead and order just the starter kit, which will come with the handle, your one set of blades, your gunk pad, and then your shave guide. Or you can sign up for the starter kit plus the subscription, which will, so like, let's say you go and order the starter kit today, a month from today, whatever that date is, it will process again for that $6.80, and you will get that pack of your 1 month supply of blades that you can use. You can cancel the subscription at any time. There's no strings attached, or like I said, you can just grab the starter kit and then grab, you know, 3 or 4 sets of replacement blades if you'd like to. But yeah, everything is down below. If you guys have any questions, I'd be happy to answer. Appreciate you guys watching this video. Make sure to give it a like if you enjoyed, and subscribe if you guys want to see more content. I talk a lot about my health journey here on this channel. I've been kind of going through some weight loss stuff and sharing it because I know that there are a lot of other women who struggle with it as well. So yeah, thanks guys so much for being here. I appreciate you. I hope you have a great blessed day, and I'll see you guys next time. Bye. Mwah.